pretty interested in the next game that's going to come in, and that is Australia-Denmark. This is if Australia, okay, potentially Australia, even draws the game at whatever score, if it's a nil-nil draw or a 1-1 or whatever, it, as long as it does not concede the game, Australia's getting into the ring. Well, that's as long as France still lose. I mean, you can't really expect France to lose from this position. You're right, they can't lose. But this is where it's exciting, because generally between Australia and Denmark, whoever wins is going to go through. So you're going to be seeing end-to-end football, and it gets exceptionally exciting. And I say to you as a neutral fan, given Australia need only a draw and Denmark need a win, if Australia managed to go one up, and then you're seeing Denmark needing two goals to go through, that's when you enjoy watching the World Cup.
I agree, but I would again say this, Australia should only be looking to score their second one.
The strategy could be, you know, early offense for Australia, try and get a goal in and then go and build a very strong wall that Denmark cannot penetrate. That is like one of the most simplest strategies to deploy. Go offense, attack, get that one goal in, and then park the bus.
Absolutely.
Unfortunately, just you've got to keep going. I think in world football, starting park the bus is
no.
See, that's it.